lot of people, when they think of fire, they think of the stuff that makes the news, the big blown up fires out in, you know, the Western US. But really, fire is a natural part of most of the world's terrestrial vegetation systems. The Midwest is full of fire-dependent ecosystems, prairies, savannas, fens, oak woodland, and even in the Northwoods, many, if not most of them, depended on fairly frequent fire. We've had decades now of seeing what a lack of fire does, and a lot of us are trying to put fire back on the ground to help restore those systems. All right, well, thanks everybody for coming out today. This is the Prairie Border North Block East Unit. It's 80 acres. We last burned it last year. Today's burn was done in an area that is pretty overgrown, had been fire suppressed for a number of decades. And we're trying to take essentially what looks like a forest, but shouldn't be, and knock it back into an oak savanna. If you walk through here where we have closed canopy forest, it's not a true forest, so there's really nothing going on in the understory. But if you open it up, put more light on the ground, you get a lot of really cool rare plants. And where you have the rare plants, the rare animals follow. These systems evolved with fire. And so we're here bringing back that natural process, that natural disturbance that these systems require in order to thrive. Should get a really good response from the native flora and fauna.
So it's about 5:20 in the morning. We're out here doing a bird survey, doing a little bit of comparison between a unit that we burned this year versus a unit we burned last year, looking for grassland birds in our restoration. We're standing in what was an ag field just about a decade ago that's been restored into a really gorgeous prairie. I can hear like a brown thrasher, some henslow sparrows, common yellow throats, brown-headed cowbirds, bobwhite quail, red-headed woodpeckers, lots of species that rely on our grasslands. Only like a percent of grasslands still remain in most of the United States. So anywhere that we can find these little pockets of ag field and restore them, and these grassland burns can come find them and say, ah, yes, I can have a home. We give them a fighting chance to survive for the long run.
Grassland birds are just in a downward spiral. What prairies are left, even if they've been preserved, if they're not managed with fire, they're gonna fill in, become a shrubland, become a forest. And then what you originally tried to conserve by protecting that site, those values that you're trying to protect go away. Keeping fire on the ground, it really helps maintain that biodiversity. There's thousands of species here, and all that diversity that we have is enhanced and promoted by the use of prescribed fire.
That's a lark sparrow. Fresh breeding plumage, you can see, kind of has that lined face pattern with multiple colors on its face, and you can see that nice bright white on the outside of its tail. That was probably the best moment of the day for me. A new species on the site and another species that's in decline just being like, heck yeah. It's one of those lovely full circle moments. All of those hard days, sweating, being covered in mosquitoes, being miserable, finding them here make every single one of those days worth it.
As the Midwest Division, we're doing a lot of things to really just expand everybody's capacity. Ramping up training, ramping up partnerships, really trying to get more fire on the ground to help restore those systems. On a human-dominated planet, if there's something that needs to happen that would benefit that system into the future, humans need to be the ones going in and doing that. Ensuring that those natural areas have what they need to survive